Okay, so play around with this. Let's give it maybe 5 minutes. There's infinitely many possible answers for this, so we'll see how many answers we can get. And I'll check in.
That's great. Thank you for checking. Nice.
Sorry. Starting. So I guess, I'll just make a little bit of a clarification. So a couple of people have asked about about criteria two, right? That's a weird looking criteria. So what we're trying to say here is that if you have the same starting height, then you wind up with equal magnitudes. So we're saying okay. So notice that these have a common value y, right? So if we sort of look at what this is saying, we're saying that everyone at height y has the same length. Play around with that and see what you can get from that. Thank you.
What? No, just 0.1. Please, also, 0.1.
Okay, do we have any attempts, anything that we could try out? See, a couple people with strong answers, good answers, yeah?
Wise word.
Yeah, sure, right, so you could say, Y squared, sure. Everything will be parallel to this guy, right? It's got the same entry in both things, and it really only depends on the value of y. Nice. Are there other things people came up with? Things they could check out?
Y.
Yeah, that also works, that's great. Yep, other things? Yep, over here.
E to the y.
Sure, perfect, yeah, perfect.
Anything contains y to the y.
Yep.
Y minus y.
Y minus?
Y.
Like this?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that is constant. Okay, so this guy is constant. Yeah, can anyone sort of like see a structure that all the examples should have?
First and second entry should be same.
Yeah, so parallel to 1, 1. Okay, everything parallel to 1, 1, has to have this structure, right? It has to have the same entry both times. And if we have equal magnitudes for anything on parallel lines, what does that give us structurally? Yeah? You can't have x involved. Exactly, perfect. So you can only, yeah, perfect, you can only depend on y somehow? And then non-constant means g is not constant. Sorry. So we need any non-constant function, g will work. Okay, so we have many, many choices there. You can put any function you feel you like. Okay, cool. Great, so that was sort of coming up with a designer vector field, a vector field that does some specific things. Just to give a sense of how this will actually be evaluated, you'll probably have a multiple choice thing, where it'll say, here are three properties, which of these has all three properties? Nice, okay, groovy.
this been the second one? How like?
Yes.
Another sort of mild skill testing question. Switching between Cartesian and polar coordinates. Let's try this out. Let's give it, say, 2 minutes. Try and write this guy as in polar coordinates. Okay, suggestions for first moves here. If you saw this question, what would you do first? Always draw the thing. Yeah, so sketch the thing. Okay, so we'll draw the region of integration. Okay, so we'll go, notice where the x's are going first. The x's go between 0 and 4. Okay, and then we've got this curve up here. Y equals 16 minus x squared. And if we do a bit of algebra,
we see we've got the equation of a circle of radius 4. Now the next move comes, so the harder move is to describe this thing in polar coordinates. So we look at the region, we see that we're going from theta equals 0 up to theta equals pi by 2.
And we can see r squared equals 2.
Yeah, and we can go, r goes from 0 to 4. So the region is all of those r theta. R theta satisfy this. And now we can write the thing in polar coordinates. Should go in the brackets. All right, we've gone from x, y to
r cos theta.
Yeah, r cos.